The next question that I got is, what is actually a music editor doing? Well, according to what the name says, that person is editing the music. But it's way more than that. And I've been lucky to work with really great music editors. So let me give a couple of credits here. I've mentioned before, Bob Bademy, very seasoned senior, has worked on incredible, amazing movies. Ken Carmen, actually, they're really good friends, more or less the same age. Incredible music editor, very seasoned, incredible legacy. And then some younger cats like Melissa Muick. She's amazing, young, very driven, very good ear. Jack Dolman, who's a fantastic music editor. Very driven too, very energetic. So these are usually the four guys that I work with if they're available, but usually they are. And so let me tell you what a music editor does and the way that I like to work with a music editor. So yes, I write music to a scene and I give that music to the music editor. But the music editor would then say to me, for instance, oh, the scene works amazing. But usually in the beginning, it's like, it works great, but when we get to this part in the scene, I wish you did something else. I wish you were, you would go here or you would go there. And I'm just like, wow, interesting. So first I take a stab at a scene and then I get an opinion back from a music editor before we even play it to the director. And we go back and forth until we both feel it's the right music for the scene. So it's very important that the composer and the music editor is like a really solid team and that you really trust each other and that you really deliver on the moments that it counts. But there's another thing that music editors do, is that that piece of music that you wrote, they're going to secretly, without you telling, but I know in the meantime that they're doing it, they're going to try that piece of music on different spots in the film and they're going to cut it up and move it around, and sometimes they ask for stems of that specific cue because they have a strong idea about something. And sometimes with the stems, they create cues that didn't even exist before. It really sparks my imagination. And so it happens a couple of times where I was still thinking what to do with a certain scene. And then, for instance, on 300 Rise of an Empire, and Melissa was the editor on that, would show me a scene was just like, wow, this is great. How did you do this? And it's like, well, I took your stems from this cue and I took the drums from that cue and I made something for you as an inspiration. And it's like, wow, this is great. And then I take that inspiration and then I write a cue with a roadmap made by a music editor that gives me an idea like, oh, wow, this is what you can do. So this shows again that film scoring is a team sport. It's not just you on your own. Just writing music. You work with your music editor, you work with your orchestrator. I've mentioned this in another movie. Obviously, you work with the director, you work with people from the studio. So it's a group of people that all are telling you what they feel, how the music potentially could be better, and what could be different. So many layers of people are involved for the end result. Yes, I am the guy who is writing the music, but I love that people tell me how I potentially could improve myself. And every time when people give me advice and when I listen to them, it always turns out to be something better that was there before. So this is what I really love about film scoring, the team effort, doing it together. And the relationship with the music editor is very important because that's the first stop that you go to with your anxious feeling of the music that you've wrote that has nobody has listened to it. So the music editor is the first one to listen to it. You go back and forth a couple of times until we both feel this is what we should play to the director, and then we play to the director, and then the whole process starts from the ground up. So I hope that answers that question.